tease about the upcoming season?
Well, we just actually did a little bit of a table read for the panel. So I guess I could give a little scoop. We do leave off season one. The werewolves have been powdered, so they've basically lost all of their memory of what has happened. And the Order is trying to figure out a way how to benefit from these powerful werewolves. So that might include like a little bit of revolution. Trying to, there's been like some like attempts and fails at it, so yeah.
Yeah. Looking back on the first season, if you were pointing out to somebody a defining scene or defining episode even that says who your character is, which one would you point out?
I definitely would say episode 7. Gabrielle really climaxes as herself within the Order. I think that's when she gets a little bit of power and kind of goes a little like uncontrolled with it, you know? She doesn't really know how to use it for the greater good. Like she thinks she is, but she definitely becomes a little bit drunk with power. Yeah, episode 7.
What was it? You said something in the panel I thought was really interesting about how you didn't know in the beginning where your character was going to go, how you just thought she was a mean girl. Talk about when you first read that first scene, when she kind of makes that turn to something more, what was that like for you?
I definitely thought she was just kind of like a mean girl. I did see a little bit that she was smarter than she was letting people know, like under this whole like, I'm not that smart facade. I was like, she's not telling people something just from some of the sides that are going to the audition. But the first time I read episode 7, I was like, I was not expecting that. I did not expect like sequences of torture scenes. But I was like, this is going to be fun. As much as like that sounds really messed up, I was so excited to play with that. Just for her to step in to more of a powerful stance with that. Yeah.
Of a backstory that they actually tell you about her to begin with? Like, what do you know that we don't? Is there a lot?
At the beginning?
Yeah.
They didn't tell me anything, really. No, we basically just got, like, the sides, a little bit of a breakdown that she was a freshman in the Order trying to get in, and she was very privileged. And that was, like, basically, and I read the sides, and I was just like, okay, there's a little bit more to her, and I tried to bring that into the audition of, like, she's not letting people know something. But other than that, it wasn't until, like, reading the scripts that we actually knew what was happening, which I think is really fun with TV, because, like, as you guys are getting excited, we kind of feel like we're going through it with you guys. We felt, like, the same way, you know? When fans were like, oh my god, I can't believe what Gabrielle did, like, well, I was like, I felt the same! I had the same reaction!
What's your feeling about this kind of material? Like, in your personal life, do you enjoy it, do you not enjoy it, or do you not enjoy it?
I'm a huge fan of Harry Potter.
Sorry.
I've always been a huge fan of Harry Potter and like fantasy and supernatural. And I grew up with two older brothers, so they've always been a good influence with me in some of that. So I love it. And I think what's so special about The Order is that it does have those dark elements, but it's mostly a comedy. And I really, really enjoy making people laugh. Just at the end of the day, if they've gone through a hard day and they just come home just to laugh at something, I really, really enjoy it.
You really think it's mostly a comedy?
I mean, maybe it's just because of my scenes, you know what I mean?
From your perspective.
Yeah, I guess with like Alyssa, yeah, I guess that's true. But I think from Gabrielle, she probably thinks everything's a comedy.
You mentioned that you didn't have much of a backstory. Do you create your own backstory when you're starting out with a new character?
Starting off with a new character, yes. I did create like a little bit of a backstory of like why Gabrielle is the way that she is. Like she probably doesn't have like a really good influence at home, seeing that she does get drunk with power. And I think because she is seen as like dumb or not so bright, she finds the Order as something to fulfill herself with. And so when Mira gives her this assignment to help out, she really takes it into her hands. But I think that's what's great with the writers. They give us like little pieces and stuff like that, but they never really give us the full story, so we kind of like help fill the gaps with that.
Yeah. go.
It's such an interesting ensemble of characters. Who would you like to see her interacting with more that she doesn't get to usually?
Definitely Alyssa. Like, we have a few scenes here and there, but because our characters just wouldn't ever, like, get along whatsoever, so I think they avoid putting us in their room. But when they do put us in their room, can I swear? I can't swear. No, oh, shit hits the fan. You know what I mean? So there's only really, like, one or two scenes in the first season that really happens, and hopefully that happens more in the second season. Also, Sarah and I are, like, really, really close, so we're just like, we want to be in scenes together.
I know you can't say maybe anything, but what have you learned about season two? Do you know a couple episodes down the line, or just that?
Well, we have read two episodes, so I don't even have as much information as I would like to. But yeah, basically, it's just basically where we left off with all the werewolves, like, memories wiped, and we're trying to find a way to benefit from that, from them not knowing what's happening. That's basically all we know. I'm really sorry.
Now, did you guys come up with your own theories, yeah, like, over the break of what was going to happen? And
I mean, we've thought about it, but nothing is, like, set in stone. Like, a lot of fans have actually, like, suggested a lot of things. Like, they want, I think one of the fans suggested, like, Philip and Alyssa had, like, a past relationship that they both forgot about or something like that. Oh, sorry. You can have it if you want, I guess.
Sorry, but I'm not feeling it.
So that would be really cool. And yeah, definitely some, like, romantic things different are going to be happening in second season, just because nobody remembers.
So would you like to know, like, where things are going? As an actor, would you like to know everything of it all the time, or do you like finding out?
I think as an actor, I kind of like knowing the minimum of what I need to know, because I do like the element of surprise. It's really, really fun. I think working in a film would be different, knowing like the beginning to the end and then filling in. But in terms of TV, I don't know. Like, I kind of liked that I didn't know where Gabrielle was going to go for episode 7, because then I got to just live with her being this, like, not the brightest girl in the room, just like meeting myths. And then when I did it, went to the dark side of it, I was like, oh, this is surprising everyone and myself, and it kind of surprises myself with, like, what I can do with it. But I know every actor is different, so some people would like to be a little bit more scary, but I just like the spontaneity of it.
Excellent. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.